نشكر الله سبحانه وتعالى على نعمه كثيرة. We're grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for His many favors and His many bounties. Those favors and bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about, وَإِن تَعُدُّ نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْسُوهَا. If you're to try to count or calculate the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, لَا تُحْسُوهَا. You can never count the blessing, not blessing, one blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And from the great blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala بَلَّغَنَا شَهْرَ رَمَضَانِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala caused us to reach the month of Ramadan. And not only did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cause us to reach the month of Ramadan, بَلْ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed us with itmam to complete the fasting in this month of Ramadan. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that guided us to complete this month of Ramadan, and يوفقنا لقبول. That we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that guided us to the month of Ramadan to accept our deeds in this month of Ramadan. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts our fast of Ramadan, our prayers in Ramadan, and all our good deeds in Ramadan. This month of Ramadan, we're so much looking forward to it. The same way that the Salaf, rahimahumullahu azza wa jal, our forefathers used to look forward to it. For our forefathers, 6 months prior to Ramadan, 6 months, they used to pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, أَيُبَلِّغَهُمْ Ramadan, to cause them to reach the month of Ramadan. So a month before Ramadan, 2 months before Ramadan, we're saying, subhanAllah, only 1 month left to Ramadan. Only 2 months left to Ramadan. And those 2 months went like this, and Ramadan came. And Ramadan came, and he left, and he departed us very quickly, subhanAllah. And this month of Ramadan, that came to us and departed us very quickly. There are some people with this month of Ramadan, with this departure, farihu bi firaqi Ramadan. There are people with the departure of the month of Ramadan, they became happy. Why did they become happy? Takhallasu min as-siyam wal ibadat. They see themselves as disposing of or getting rid of the fasting and other acts of ibadat, other acts of worship that was heavy and burdensome upon them. They found it heavy and burdensome. And there's some other people, farihu bi itmam Ramadan. There's some other people, they became happy with the completion of the month of Ramadan. Not the departure, but the completing the month of Ramadan. Because they hope true that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive them of their sins due to the acts they did in Ramadan. For the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Man sama Ramadan imanan wa ihtisaban, ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbi." Whoever fasts the month of Ramadan out of iman and hoping for reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all his previous sins will be forgiven. They're happy with the completion of Ramadan because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Man qama Ramadan," whoever stands in prayer in Ramadan, imanan wa ihtisaban, out of iman and hoping reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ghufira ma taqaddama lahu min dhanbi, his previous sins will be forgiven. Man qama laylatul qadr, whoever stands laylatul qadr out of iman and hoping for reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all his previous sins will be forgiven. So they're happy with the completion of Ramadan due to these great actions they undertook in the month of Ramadan. These three things, standing in prayer, laylatul qadr, and fasting for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there's a great difference between being happy with the departure of Ramadan and with the completion of Ramadan. Great difference. And we pray that Allah ta'ala makes us those who are happy with the completion of Ramadan. But what we need to ask ourselves, what are the signs to know what we belong to? Are we of those who are happy be firaqi Ramadan, with the departure of Ramadan, or be itmami Ramadan, or the completion of Ramadan? From the signs that a person is happy with the departure of Ramadan, is happy with the fact that he doesn't have to do those acts of ibadat, that after Ramadan, he goes back to disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَيَتَهَاوَنُ فِي الْوَاجِبَاتِ. And when it comes to the obligations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he becomes complacent. It becomes complacent and neglectful. These are from the signs that a person is happy Ramadan is over. And this, unfortunately, is something that's not just manifest in individuals, but as a society, as a community. That if you notice today, the first day of Eid, Salatul Fajr, compared to the other Salatul Fajr, empty. In Ramadan, the masjid was full for Fajr. Immediately, for Dhuhr, for Asr, for Maghrib and Isha. For if you want to know yourself, are you happy that Ramadan has left you? Look at your acts of obedience when it comes to the obligation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you're happy, you will know that after this, you become complacent regarding obligations. And one of the most important obligations, or the worst thing for a person to become complacent with, is salah. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, "Kutiba alaykum as-siyam," that fasting has been prescribed for you. Also said, "Inna salata kanat ala al-mu'minin kitaban mawquta." That prayer has been prescribed for the believers at set times. And yes, we fasted out of iman, faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But this fasting which we did, if a person does not fast out of laziness or disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most authentic opinion, the person is sinful, committed a major sin, but he's not a non-Muslim. He doesn't leave Islam. However, this salah that people become complacent with after Ramadan. At-Tabi'i, rahimahullahu ta'ala, said about the Sahaba, the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, كَانَ لَا يَرَوْنَ شَيْئًا مِنَ الْأَعْمَالِ تَرْكُهُ كُفُرٌ إِلَّا الصَّلَاةِ. The Sahaba radiallahu anhum, they did not believe leaving off any actions, any obligation makes you a kafir, takes us out of the fold of Islam, إِلَّا الصَّلَاةِ, except for salah. And anybody who is complacent regarding the salah will be complacent regarding everything else. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about this salah, إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ تَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ, that this salah is what prevents you from illicit behaviors and evil. فَخَلَفَ مِن بَعْدِهِمْ قَوْمٌ أَضَاعُوا الصَّلَاةَ, that after them came a people, they were complacent concerning the salah. وَاتَّبَعُوا الشَّهَوَاتِ, and they followed their desires. So if you abandon your salah, everything else you abandon. وَالْمَعَاصِ بَعْدَ الطَّاعَاتِ, I want us all to know this, because I pray sincerely that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts our deeds in Ramadan. وَلَكِنْ, however, الْمَعَاصِ بَعْدَ الطَّاعَاتِ, engaging regularly, habitually in sin after Ramadan, رُبَمَ تَحِيطُ بِهَا, maybe your sins will surround all the good deeds during Ramadan. وَتَكُونَ أَكْتَرُ مِنْهَا, and maybe those sins will become more than the acts of obedience during Ramadan. فَلَا يَكُنْ لِلْعَامِلِ سِوَى التَّعْبِ, subhanAllah. And therefore, the one who did in Ramadan, fasted, prayed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will not have anything for me except for what? For ta'ab, except for exhaustion and tiredness. So we don't want to be of those the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said about, رُبَّ الصَّائِمْ حَظُّهُ مِنَ الصِّيَامِ الْجُوعُ وَالْعَطَشِ. Maybe one that fasted, the only thing he got from his fast, الْجُوعُ وَالْعَطَشِ, it's just hunger and thirst. رُبَّ قَائِمْ حَظُّهُ مِنَ الْقِيَامِ السَّهَرِ, and maybe the one that stood and prayed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, including Ramadan at night, maybe the only thing he benefited from it was a sahar, tiredness, exhaustion, and staying up at night. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not make us those people. These are the signs that a person is happy that yes, Ramadan is over, that he engages in sins and gives up the obligation. And the greatest obligation is salah. Don't give that up, no matter what. No matter what, for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, upon his deathbed, what was his last words? As-salatu as-salah. On his deathbed, salah, salah, salah. And with our children likewise, we have to order them with the salah. And from the signs for us to know, did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept Ramadan? Is that Ramadan accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Min alamati thalik, from the signs of that, is that the Salaf used to say, ثواب الحسنة الحسنة بعدها, the reward for a good deed is that you continue upon a good deed after that good deed. فمن عمل حسنة, so whoever does a good deed, ثم أتبعها بحسنة كان ذلك علامة القبول, Oh, alamatul qubur. Whoever does a good deed and then follows it up with a good deed, this is a sign Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has accepted that deed. Kama man amila hasana thumma atba'aha bisayya. Likewise, whoever does a good deed like this month of Ramadan, the fasting, the praying, and then he follows it up with an evil deed, كان ذلك علامة رد الحسن وعدم القبول. This is a sign that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has rejected that good deed and that deed is not accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is علامة قبول or قبول. The signs that Allah ta'ala has accepted in Ramadan. So we should be of people that after Ramadan, what we did from the obligations, I'm not talking about extra deeds, we continue upon them. Because we're ibadur Rahman, servants of Ar-Rahman, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have to continue upon the obligations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We fast in Ramadan, why? Imanan, out of faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what did the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said? When the Sahabi radiallahu anhu, he came to say, Ya Rasulullah, qul fil Islam, qawlan la as'al ahadin ghayrak. Tell me something in Islam that I could ask nobody but you. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Qul, say, Amantu billah, I believe in Allah. The same way we fast in Ramadan, of what? Belief. Thumma istaqim. And then be upright and then be consistent. Not just in Ramadan. So pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes us of those who are happy by completion of Ramadan. And those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has accepted their deeds in this month of Ramadan that has left us. Wa aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah. Like we said, from the signs that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has accepted on Ramadan is that a person, it continues upon goodness. And from the signs it's not been accepted that it goes back to disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, leaves out the obligation. And that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَإِن تَوَلَّوْا. If they were to turn away. Meaning, likewise, after Ramadan, those people that used to come to the masjid, they don't come anymore. They don't pray on time. فَإِن تَوَلَّوْا فَعْلَمْ. If they were to turn away Muhammad, no. أَنَّمَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهِ لِيُصِيبَهُمْ بِبَعْضِ ذُنُوبِهِمْ. That Allah wants to afflict punishment upon them due to their sins. So the month of Ramadan is not the only month of Salah. Likewise, Ramadan, Shahru al-Siyam. The month of Ramadan is the month of fasting. And that month or the season of fasting has left us now, has left us. وَلَكِنْ لَمْ تَنْقَطِئَ الْأَعْمَالُ الصَّالِحَةِ. However, good deeds has not ceased. There's no season, there's no time for good deeds. So whatever we did in Ramadan from good deeds, such as fasting, it doesn't cease just with Ramadan. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Man sama Ramadan, thum atba'ahu bi sitti ayyam shawwal, kana kasiyam ad-dahr." Whoever fasts the month of Ramadan and then follows it up with fasting six days of Shawwal, is as though he's fasted for the whole ad-dahr, the whole year. So fasting not just in Ramadan. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said about Mondays and Thursdays, إِنَّ الْأَعْمَالِ تُعْرَضُ فِيهَا عَلَى اللَّهِ. Mondays and Thursdays is when the angels, they come and they take our deeds to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَأُحِبُّ أَنْ يُعْرَضْ عَمَلِي وَأَنَا صَائِمٌ. I want my actions to be presented before Allah azza wa jal on Monday and Thursday, وَأَنَا صَائِمٌ, and I'm fasting. So Monday and Thursday is another day we should practice the sunnah to fast. Likewise, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, he said, أَوْصَانِ خَلِيلِ بِثَلَاثَ. My beloved advised me with three things. وَأَنْ لَأَدَعَهُنْ. And to never leave these three things. Never ever leave these three things. What are these three things? صَلَاتُ الدُّحَى. The Salah الدُّحَى. كَذَلِكَ الْوِتْرِ. The witr prayer, which you prayed in Ramadan, is not just for Ramadan. He said, never leave them. To the point that subhanAllah, Imam Ahmed rahimahullah ta'ala, he was asked about a person who never prays witr, never. Imam Ahmed said, Rajulun su is an evil man. Witr is not just for Ramadan. Likewise, siyam thalathi ayyam in kulli shahr, to fast 3 days of the month, the white days. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, siyam thalathi ayyam in kulli shahr, ka siyam iddahr kulli. If you fast 3 days each month, the 13th, 14th, and 15th of the white days, is that you fasted the whole year. Likewise, Dhul Hijjah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never missed the fast of Dhul Hijjah, Ashr, the 10th of Dhul Hijjah, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, fasting, you kafiru sanatain al-madiya, that fasting on the Dhul Hijjah, it expiates 2 years, the previous year and the coming year. We should never give up fasting, even after Ramadan. Likewise, the Qiyam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, afdalu salah, the best salah, ba'da al-maktuba, after the obligatory salah. Because the obligatory salah, you walk into dhuhr in the heat. It is better for you than standing in tarawih and crying. And you don't pay the obligatory salah. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, la yataqarrab ilayya abdi. You want to be close to Allah? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, my servant will never ever get close to me. Illa bimaftaratu alayhi, except by doing that which is obligatory upon him. You will never get close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And from the greatest things you could do to get close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is salah. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَرَأَيْتَ الَّذِي يَنْهَى. Do you not see the one who prohibits? عَبْدًا إِذَا صَلَّى. The servant when he's praying. What does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say? And I, كَلَّا. Nay, do not obey him. فَسْجُدْ. Prostrate. وَقْتَرِبْ. Draw close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Which is why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَقْرَبُ مَا يَكُونُ الْعَبْدُ. Subhanallah. The closest a person will ever be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wa huwa sajid, when he's in sujood. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, afdalu salah ba'da al-maktuba, the best salah after the obligatory salah, as-salah fi jawfi al-layl, salah in the middle of the night. At that point where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends from the heavens, saying, hal min sa'il, is there anybody asking me, fa u'tiya, so I may give. Hal min da'i, is there anybody calling upon me, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so I may answer him. Is there anybody asking for my forgiveness, so I may forgive him. This is not just in Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about the people of Jannah, that really wants Jannah, qaleelun min al-layli ma yahja'oon, they sleep a very little of the night, wa bil ashari hum yastaghfirun, and before fajr, ashab jam'u waqtu jam'u sahar, the time of sahur, or suhoor, they're asking Allah Ta'ala's forgiveness. And the Salaf, rahimahumullah azza wa jal, our forefathers, the same way we visit each other now, dhuhr, asr, maghrib, isha. Do you know what time they used to visit each other? They used to visit each other waqtu sahar, the time of suhoor, not in Ramadan. They used to visit each other time of suhoor. And if they found one of them sleeping, they used to say, afi hadha al-waqt yanam al-abd al-muslim, does a true servant to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, does he sleep at this time? At the time of sahar? So my dear brothers and sisters, I end what we began with. And that's the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ya ayyuha alladhina amanu taqullah. Oh, you believe, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, haqqa tuqati, as he should truly be feared. فَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ, do not die, إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ, except you're in a state of submission. Because the way Ramadan came and left us is a sign that our life, if you live 60 years, 70 years, 80 years, it will come and leave you like that. And when it's Yawm al-Qiyamah, the day they see it, كَأَنَّهُمْ لَمْ يَلْبَثُوا, people will think they only spent upon the face of the earth, عَشِيَّ أَوْ دُحَاهَا, just a night, a part of the night or a part of the day. Our life is going to come and leave us. So die in a state of Islam. I leave you with the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَعْبُدْ رَبَّكَ, continue worshipping your Lord, حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ, until yaqeen, it comes to you. وَيَقِينُ هُوَ الْمَوْتِ, and yaqeen, certainty, is death. There are people, last Ramadan, they were with us, they're not with us now. And for the young people as well, do not think, okay, 70, 80, I'll start worshipping Allah Azza wa Jal. There's a person, a close family friend, 2 days, just 2 days before Ramadan, 2 days or day before Ramadan, he collapsed. He collapsed. He had a blood clot that went to the head, brainstem. brain stem, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him a shifa. That this brain stem clot is so dangerous. Two scenarios: either you die, and in most cases you come out of it and you're locked in. The only thing you could do is communicate with your eyes. Did you think this will happen for Ramadan? We pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ash-shafi an yashfiyahu, that Allah ta'ala ash-shafi gives him a shifa. So we pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts our deeds. Taqabbalallahu minna wa minkum. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept it from you and from us. And we pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala al-muqallib al-qulub, the one that alternates the heart. An yuthabbit qulubana ala deenik, to keep our heart firm upon the deen. Rabbana atina fi dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasanatan wa qina adhab an-nar. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب.